Hi, I'm Don Sackett, co-founder, CEO of SciAps, and we're here today to show this amazing new Geochem Pro software. I'm here with my brilliant software manager, Katarina, and our biz dev guy out of Vancouver, Canada, Ben, who's much better than our biz dev guy out of Australia. And anyway, so what we're gonna do, we'll show Geochem Pro, which is, it uses our LIBS device, and it does elemental mapping of a rock or a material, so you can actually look in 100 or so micron spots to get elemental data across the surface, and you can plot it out and map it. So we're having great success with this LIBS unit. A really popular application right now is in-field measurements of lithium, especially. Lithium's obviously really, really high demand element because of the EV market. So we've got our handheld LIBS, which does the full range of elements, including lithium. And we also have a smaller handheld that is set up just to do lithium and a few related elements in rocks and in the future brines. So that's a new area coming along later on doing lithium brines. Anyway, enough about this and me. Show us what you got there, Katarina. Tell us about this great new software.
Okay, so today we would like to introduce you a new feature in our software. Previously, we were talking about export management in the cloud. Now we have a local version of desktop application that you could use to control your analyzer remotely.
This can desktop or cloud. You can do either one.
You could do, some customers prefer to have local version. Why?
Yeah.
Because they may not have Wi-Fi coverage. They could be in the middle of nowhere.
Canada.
Well, I didn't mean Canada.
Wi-Fi's
okay.
Coming. Okay.
Yes.
Or Australia.
Or Australia.
Okay, all right. Got it.
Yeah, so they're in the middle of nowhere. They don't have Wi-Fi, but they do have a connection. And as you can see on my laptop, I don't have any Wi-Fi. Analyzer does not have any Wi-Fi. But we could still take a test, and I want to show you.
Okay.
So Ben is holding a ruler. It's a very important job because, as you could see on the screen, we're trying to hit this gold coating spot.
And that's about 300 microns diameter.
Yes.
Okay.
So, and I'm going to start the test. And test is in progress. And as you could see actually on the analyzer, it's splashing. But you see the raster going on, right? Do you see it?
Yeah. So the beam, the LIBS does a 256 test.
Snake pattern.
In a 16 by 16 raster to look at a spot. And then it looks at each spectrum from each of those 256 shots to look at elemental content as a function of two-dimensional position, right? That's what we're doing?
Exactly.
Exactly. All right.
Yeah. Yeah. So why do we care about this, Ben?
Yeah, so, it's a micro-analytical technique that gives you, information, visual information on the elemental partitioning in a sample, right? So it allows you to, spatially resolve the distribution of elements in a sample. And that's super important for, geochem studies. Like, for example, if you've got gold mineralization, you want to know what it's associated with. You could shoot the surrounding minerals that are, carrying and depositing the gold and get an idea of, the alteration, how it's been deposited in the rocks. So really, really interesting. Kind of takes the infield geochem to the next level.
Ben, can I ask you a question? So,
yeah.
We make an XRF, other people make XRF, they take a rock, they shoot it or they crush it, homogenize it and shoot it, and they get total elemental chemistry, like total copper, total whatever. So why is doing this better in some cases than just pulverizing a rock and getting a broad chemistry?
Yeah, no, it's a great question. So this kind of, gives you a different data set, and it's a valuable data set because it tells you a little bit more about the rocks, not just the chemistry or not the grade of the, the ore.
So is this like in a rock, if you take a rock, the minerals you may be looking for are in little spots along that rock. It's not homogeneous, obviously. It's not like a liquid. So if you want to analyze that with XRF, you crush it up and you get a broad average of what's there. But if you shoot it with this, you can sort of pinpoint each little spot in that rock and know, there's three elements at this spot, but they're not here in this other spot.
Yeah.
So that kind of gives you an idea, this could be this mineral, but maybe not that mineral, because I see these three minerals together in this tiny 100 micron location. Is that fair?
Exactly. It's super valuable. It's pretty, you know, it's the kind of stuff that is done in a lab, and we're trying to bring it to the field.
All right. It's pretty boring, huh?
Guys, you stole my show.
No. Now you get...
Yeah, but you're the one...
See, we're just talking...
Just hold on a second. No one noticed how quickly the result got back. So we got results almost instantly, right?
We did.
We collect spectrum
okay.
from all 256 shots, and you could see them on the list. So you could explore one by one. See? Like it's a second one.
Right.
And then...
So these are all the little spots that we shot along that rock.
Exactly.
Okay.
And
nice.
You can compare them, so you could multi-select, and you could see two of them together, and you could see
them.
The
all
difference.
Right.
See?
Show the picture.
That's it.
So what do you...
Hold on a second. So let me show you the map. So that's why...
See, this is an awesome tool you've developed.
It is
we're,
awesome
we're,
tool.
We're happy, excited about it.
Don't want me to talk and explain what
no,
it does.
No.
Okay.
Right. All right, keep talking.
So, the main feature is the heat map. So where you could select a particular element and get heat map presentation of it. As you know, this ruler.
Look at that.
Yeah, look at that. It has this tiny, tiny spot of gold.
300 microns.
Yes, like, and we hit exactly that spot.
So this is the gold you're hitting, and this is the area that we were hitting that didn't have anything.
Exactly.
So that's a great heat map.
See how cool it is?
Yeah, it's very cool.
It shows also emission lines. You could also zoom in on a particular, like, you know, area of the graph.
Yeah.
You could even zoom in even more.
Yeah.
If you want to explore.
That's
neat. You can go back, and we could show emission lines here, and you could choose your gold. And see whether, boom.
Look at all those gold lines.
Mm-hmm.
Very nice. Okay, so here's the thing. So if we don't talk so much, will you shoot another sample for us?
Yes, if
and
you don't talk so much, yes.
Okay,
we will,
all right, we'll
sure.
be quiet. All
so
right.
we're gonna use a copper tape, and we're gonna cover sample,
okay.
right? And let's try to shoot it. Let's position it. Let me see the screen.
There's the camera.
Here's the camera.
All right, good. All right,
yeah.
So we got this thing. You've got copper on one half and iron on the other half.
Okay.
So we're going to show, we're going to snake back and forth, take spectra, and we're going to show what's going on. Is that the idea?
Yes.
All right.
Again.
Let's see how we look
Let's
here.
Run.
So this takes about, what, 15 seconds to do all these tests, we think?
Yeah, but you can get results immediately. You saw the test appears almost right away, and you can explore the spectra, you can explore individual spectrum. And also you could see a snake pattern on a picture that we usually take post-fact, and also we take one picture before the test, so user could compare that. It's something that's coming, it's not in this particular demonstration, but we will show it next time.
Next time.
Hold on. So what do you expect to see? No, I want to know, what do you expect to see?
I expect to see a blob of iron or copper on one half of the map and a blob of the other element on the other half. So I think you should go down that list of yours and pick. Yeah, that'll work. Look at that. Now go click iron. What's going to happen now?
Nice.
Look at that. So the heat map is the brighter the red, the higher the concentration or intensity.
Yes.
So you got your iron, you got your copper.
Absolutely. See, beautiful.
So that's how you can see elements in a little spot on these things.
Yes.
All right. Should we do the real deal?
Yes.
Put it to a test with a real rock.
All right, so we've got a piece of drill core here.
Okay.
And it's from a gold project. And we've got a little veinlet here that we're going to shoot. We're going to kind of look at the elemental distribution around that. See what
All right.
Show you.
So the idea is to put the vein right in the middle of the screen there, right?
I'm holding.
There it is.
There, nice.
It just
Perfect.
Needs a gentle touch. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm going to hold it too. Okay.
Scan. All right, here we go. A few seconds.
You can talk while I'm holding the
So again, we're just snaking the raster back and forth across that vein. And the idea is what we hope we'll see is some element that makes up that vein showing up on that heat map.
Yes.
Is that what I'm looking for?
Mm-hmm,
exactly.
All right. Time.
Okay, yes. Okay, so what do we expect to see in this case? Because I have no idea what to expect in this rock, to be honest with you.
What do you think, Ben? What's that vein?
Yeah,
you're the geologist here.
Yeah,
you tell us.
It looks like a chlorite veinlet. So it looks like a little fracture that's been filled with, you know, that's been, you know, altered, and you've got some chloride alteration there. So, you know, it should have a whole bunch of different.
Should we look at iron or what? What do you think?
You can look at iron. You can look at even like.
He doesn't know. Just click iron.
There we go.
Wow.
Look at that.
All right.
You were right, Ben. I'm just teasing. Look at that.
So there's a good operator.
There's your vein right there. So, okay. So like an XRF, you would just shoot that in a sort of an overall average. You might see some iron, you might not, but it won't tell you anything other than there's iron someplace in there. Whereas this, we could know, oh, that vein is iron, but on either side of that vein, there's no iron because it's all in light blue, meaning no intensity of iron.
I feel like the roller mall. That's my personal choice. Yeah.
All right. That's really
not bad,
cool.
Though. That's pretty good, you know. And so
that's really good.
Yeah, that's the kind of like stuff that happens at a lab typically.
Yeah.
You know, but we're bringing it to the field.
All right.
In a portable handheld instrument. So
that's the revolutionary thing. Not only are we doing light elements like lithium, boron, beryllium, carbon in the field now with a handheld, but we're also being able to do some spatial work of looking at veins and distribution of some of these elements in a heat map, right?
Yeah, that's right. Mineral chemistry stuff. Yeah. And yeah, really kind of.
All right.
Yeah.
There you go. So that's it. So that's the LIBS. That's the new Geochem Pro software for heat mapping. Thank you very much. That's
You're
really
welcome.
A nice piece of software. We appreciate all your hard work on that. Thank you for, you know, going all around.
For everything else and
for going all
the
around
work.
Latin America and Canada selling these things.
Well, thank you. Thank you guys both. Yeah.
Excellent.
All right.
See you.